ברכות על ראשיכן, על מותכן. סלחו לנו על המראה הבלתי מצוחצח שאינו הולם יופי של גברות כגון חן. הנני דון קיחוט מלה מנצ'ה, וזה נושא כלה לעתיד סנצ'ו פנסה.
Welcome everybody. I'm very glad, very excited to be here. Welcome Jesus and Juan.
I'm a Colombian novelist and I'm sitting here with a Spanish novelist and an Israeli novelist in Israel discussing Don Quixote in English with an iPhone. So this is a metaphor of his presence in our world. Don Quixote, the novel, was published in 1605. What a great novel does when it's published is take us to places where we had never been before.
I love the way that Cervantes talks about himself. This sense of humor, this ability to look himself in the mirror and say, oh my God, you're not so the best writer in the world. This irony is something that I love in this novel, amazing novel full of liars and full of complexity.
The power of irony in a novel means creating a space, creating a world in which two opposite ideas are at the same time true. Don Quixote is the craziest man in the whole of Spain, and at the same time, he's the only sane man in Spain.
מה מבדיל בין אסיר לאביר? הקסדה? הנה, קח את הקסדה. עכשיו אתה אביר ואני אסיר. תגידו שהשריון עושה את האדם? לא ולא. הנה, אני מוריד את השריון. האם אני לא אדם? אדם אני וגם אתם.
A crazy man is allowed to say everything as a child or as a drunken man. And it's a way that probably he avoids the censorship and he's able to criticize to justice, to bureaucracy, to the power, everything in that moment of the history of Spain.
Cervantes invented this territory in which we suspend for the time of the reading, we suspend our very human tendency to judge and to say this is true and this is false.
Jesus, it would be arbitrary to search traces of Cervantes in any Spanish novel, but in fact it's not impossible to find Don Quixote-ish aspects in your book. Is Cervantes still a father figure that Spanish writers have to deal with?
I think it's clear that it's a big figure, Cervantes, and for many reasons. Everybody who approached Cervantes with Don Quixote get really amused by the complexity and the modernity of a text. Of course, I'm part of this tradition.
שמי דון אלוורו טרפה, ענה האורח. על זאת השיב דון קיחוטה, סבור אני שבלי ספק, כבודו הוא דון אלוורו טרפה שעליו מסופר בחלק השני של סיפורו של דון קיחוטה דה למנצ'ה, שזה אתה הוציאו לאור מחבר חדש.
It was the most successful book of his time, probably. So successful that another writer, under a false name, decided to publish in 1614 a second part, stealing Don Quixote and Sancho from Miguel de Cervantes. Cervantes knew that this book was coming. He hurried up, he finished his own second part, and published it in 1615. And the way he took revenge is one of the great moments in world literature. The things we do now, the things we are able to do now with fiction, comes from this little chapter. It's the chapter in which a character from Avellaneda, the apocryphal Don Quixote, comes into the real second part of Don Quixote. And he meets Don Quixote and Sancho. Don Quixote asks Álvaro Tarfe to go to the authorities and confess in writing that the actual Don Quixote and Sancho are much more fun.
So apart from being an amazingly elegant revenge on his plagiarist, the structure of fiction within fiction within fiction here is so elaborate that one gets dizzy. We still can be amazed and teased by a writer that has been dead for 400 years. Thank you so much, really, for this fascinating talk, for your sincere and deep answers. Juan Gabriel Vázquez, Jesús Carrasco, muchas gracias. Toda rabah.